Hello, this is H.J. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! Since last time, I grinded up to level 33 to get Learn Kafrizzle for Maya there. And I also... Oh yeah, you see the barrier up there? We gotta find a way to get past that. But I also went back and purchased a flowing dress for Meena off-screen. I went back to El Ferrado and did that. But anyway, you got Emperor Wyverns, they're susceptible to thwack. So just sub in Kiryl, boom, got him, piss off. Move on with life. But yeah, pretty much you get everyone up to level 33, you should be in pretty good shape. I mean, there are some more spells, especially for solo, but most of them, I'm not really interested in. So. But anyway, I've arranged my party as I have listed in the video description for now, and that's my default setup, though. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to alter my setup for the boss fight specifically. You want dragon males, so that way you can prevent breath damage there. That's really good. I want the miracle sword for solo there, just because Kiryl's not going to be doing anything here. And the liquid metal shield to Meena, also to block breath damage. So, yeah, we got all that good stuff there. Flowing dresses all around. We're set and ready to go. Hey, haven't I seen you somewhere before? Oh, yeah, you're Mucifer. For boss time! This is Barbados, so... Attack. We want to use Insulate to protect against his breath attacks. And then get a good sap going on. Yeah, Insulate is really good. It is, like, mandatory at this point in the game, because if you don't have that and the breath protecting equipment, he will kill you. But I have that, so he shouldn't be able to touch me. Or I could be wrong. But yeah, you see, it's not even touching us with his breath attacks, so... Alright, there we go. So yeah, Meena, start healing there, and once you've got sap going, then we'll use Oomph. Ow! Maybe I should have had some magic protecting equipment. Oh well. But anyway, Barbados is immune to... What is it? He's immune to Frizzle, which is why I didn't want to bring Maya around. But as we were kind of told earlier, there's these four barriers that we gotta clear in order to get into the castle there. So... We gotta fight four boss fights to do that, and I am going to be putting everyone to use at one point in time or another. So, and I'm not just doing that just to, you know, make things useful. He's also susceptible to crack there. But yeah, I'm not just, you know, making everyone useful just because I'm doing it because they're actually useful. There's a specific reason why I'm using each party member. I'm not just, like, forcing the issue. So, let's just attack for now. I think Ragnar's doing okay, but maybe not so much anymore, but... Uh-oh, Insulate's wearing off. Did sap wear off? I might need to reestablish that. Well, let me see if it wears off from here first. Uh-oh. Nuts! My Insulate wore off! Yeah, imagine if we had no breath-protecting equipment. Even Borya has the flowing dress there. But yeah, holy cow. Nuts. Well, at least I got Insulate going. That's why I gave Meena the... What is it? The Meteorite Bracer, that's it. So, yeah, heal up there, and now let's get Sap going. It's probably worn off by now. I probably missed it because the text is moving so quickly. Oh well, I don't want it like, taking forever to finish this guy. Those are some big horns you got there, man. Holy cow. See, Oomph is worn off, so let's get that going. One thing with Oomph and the Miracle Sword is that the HP that the Miracle Sword restores to you is based on the damage you deal. So if you Oomph someone with the Miracle Sword, you practically don't have to heal them at all. But anyway, as you noticed, we won another miracle sword from him. That's the reason why I wanted to kill him first. So that way I could pick that up for the later boss fights there. Well, alright, there we go. So yeah, it's kind of like Final Fantasy V, where you got to take down all those barrier towers, except, well, And that there you only have to take down one. Here you gotta take down, take them all down. So, okay, so for the boss here, let's give that new miracle sword to Kiryl, because I'm going to sub him in now. And we're gonna wanna get some magic protecting equipment too, sooner or later. So let's give the liquid metal armor to Kiryl. Yeah, he can equip some decent stuff as far as like heavy armor goes. Not the best, but not the worst either. So let's give the flowing dress, or hand it down to Maya there for some magic protection and such. Want the meteorite bracer so she can get in sap first before everyone else attacks, or maybe Alena, but. And the Zenithian armor on Solo for some more magic protection. And I think we should be good. So we want Solo, Kiryl, Alena, and Maya. But yeah, I love the Miracle Sword better than the Zenithian sword. It's too bad the Zenithian sword doesn't restore your HP. Yeah, it doesn't do that. Miracle Sword is just so much better for a small decrease in attack power. Oh, did I get the, the Liquid Metal Shield? Why not give it to Maya? You don't have to, but you might as well. I mean, just for the raw defense alone. Now, this part's a little tricky, and you're going to hate me for how easy I'm going to make this look, viewers. But see, we got these statues here, and we can't get past them. If you try to get past them, come on. Nuts. Yeah, they throw you out. So there's a very easy way of getting past them, though. Just do that. Ha! There we go. I don't know how you're supposed to get past them, but that's how I like to do it. Uh-oh. Balzac, is that you? Oh, sure, why not? What reward is that? Boss time! Nuts. Yeah, if you turn around like that, he'll get a sneak attack in on you. So, we're not gonna let that happen. If you just stay here and then talk to him again, then you don't get the back attack, so, just a little thing to throw in there, so. First things first, we want to get Kaba on everyone. This is a pretty straightforward fight. And Sap on him. But he mostly uses physical attacks. And that's mostly all he does, really. He does a little other things, but anyway. So yeah, get double Kaba going, we got Sap. Now let's use our new Kafrizzle spell. Wow, look at that damage! Yeah, it's pretty good stuff there. That's one reason why I like Maya. She just deals so much more damage to bosses than Borya does. I don't even care about Oomph. I mean, Oomph is okay. It depends on the situation, really. But if they're susceptible to Kafrizzle, I would absolutely just go for that instead of worrying about Oomph and then risk having Borya being useless because he's fairly susceptible to Crackle, but I like Kafrizzle better. Uh-oh, his defense got back down, so let's sap him again. I'm not even worried about him casting Kasap on me at all, because by the time we get there, he's already dead. An Oaken Club, that's it? That was what you were whacking me upside the head with? No wonder you weren't dealing that much damage to me. Well, there you go. So, alright, two down. Two to go. In the NES version, there's a... what is it? There's a mini medal in one of these shrines. I forget which one it is. But in this version, nah, we don't get that. So, yeah, after killing half of them, might be a good idea to heal up there. Wonder why they always have these havens in the final area of the game. They did that in Dragon Quest II. 3 didn't have that. I mean, they had towns, but... these shrines. They have it in this game. I think they have it in the next game. I forget about 6, though. Well, whatever. But anyway, heal up there. I like going in clockwise order. Really, once you get the Miracle Sword, you can do them, the rest of them in whatever order you want. So, anyway, for this one... Let's see. We want... Solo, Kiryl, Meena, and Borya. There we go. And for this one, it's not so much about the equipment that you want. I mean, I'll move some things around. But let's see. Yeah, the only thing I'm really concerned about is the liquid metal shield for some breath protection. For the most part, that should be good. Oh, yeah, and the flowing dress, of course. Now, this one's a little tricky. We want to get some other weapons out of my bag to use for this boss fight there. Just make sure I got everything else. Okay, yeah, I think we're good. So, first things first, we want to get the Icicle Dirk. And give that to Solo or Kiryl, whoever you prefer. And the Staff of Divine Wrath, we want to give that to Kiryl there. So, yeah, always hold on to your old equipment, viewers. At this point in the game. Unless I tell you to sell something. Let's see. Ah, there's the guy. I'm trying to remember what enemy that looks like. Oh, yeah, he looks just like a palette swap of the red dragons or the blue dragons. For boss time! And there's three of them. Holy cow, I'm not prepared for three enemies in a boss fight. Or am I? Yeah, what you want to do here is use Kabuff twice, and you want to use Crackle, Cut-Crackle, or Kaswoosh. Yeah, look at that damage! But yeah, the thing with this boss fight is a little tricky, because you gotta kill them all at once, because if you don't, then I think, let's see what they do. I forget whether it's they summon help or they just revive them. I forget. But you want to kill them all at once. So use multi-targeting attacks, whatever you got. The only elements they are susceptible to are Frizz, Crack, and Whoosh. Obviously, you don't want to use Frizzle because you want mass damage. So Crack and Whoosh, pretty much the way to go here. Unfortunately, they're not calling for backup there. Okay, one more hit ought to do. Go. Ha! There we go. Well, easy enough. They only got 450 HP, but the trick is the problem that you can have with them is how they they can revive each other. Once you know that, then you're fine. So, all right, there we go. Three down. One more left to go. But who was behind the murder of Rose? Was it really a man, as we were told? Or someone else? Find out next time on Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! This is H.G. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!